Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really neat project, and guess what? You don't even need a vinyl cutter to do it. What we're talking about today is the ability to make reusable stencils. All right, guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and I just want to really stress right off the bat that I am doing this in Silhouette Studio, but you do not have to do this in Silhouette Studio. You can actually use SVG files in Silhouette Studio. You can use them in Cricut Design Space. You can use them in Microsoft Word. So there are a lot of different things that you can do with these files. I am showing you in Silhouette Studio because I did make a slight modification just to really get the most out of this design. And that's what I'm going to teach you today. But really, for this project, there is no cutting, there is no weeding. You actually are not going to use your cutting machine at all. So I'm going to go ahead and jump on in, but basically what I need to do is I need to print this on a transparency that's going to pair up with my stencil material. So I'll show you more about that, but because this is a printable, I really want it to utilize the full size of this. This is set up to be a letter size piece of paper here. But as you can see, the little tails, the glyphs on my matters word, they extend farther than the sheet. So what I did just to, not that I don't love it that way, I do, but it would make me put my design a lot smaller. So I just grabbed my knife tool and I sliced those pieces, not permanently, but I sliced them for the time being. And let's zoom back out, because then what I did was I shrunk them in to be the same as the other pieces, okay? I just used my directional arrows, notched that over a little bit. Same thing over here. Let's go ahead and tap it over and then shrink it down. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my drag box and I'm going to drag it through the middle words and the new glyphs that I just sized down, right click and weld those back together. Okay, so super easy to do, just something I wanted to show you guys. That way you don't feel like you have to fit everything on one paper the way that it is. You can make modifications. So I'm just gonna move some of those little hearts there. So I am gonna make just a few more modifications. Here, let's see, because I ungrouped this design, let's make sure that it gets grouped back together. And then I'm actually going to recenter. Because if you notice, it's actually the kindness is over a little bit farther than some of the other pieces of the design. That'll make more sense in a minute. There we go. So now I just want you to watch what happens. I'm gonna select this whole thing and recenter them. There we go. Now group it. Sometimes it's those little minor adjustments that really can make a big difference. All right, now we're going to lock our aspect ratio and we want to make sure that this is, I would say, 8 inches wide, and then it'll size it down to be just about 10.5 inches tall, high. So we'll center the page. The next thing we need to do is I'm going to right click and I'm going to flip horizontally. That's because I need to print this design mirrored. That is what is suggested by the manufacturer. So that's what we're going to do. Now let's go ahead and talk about print settings. I'm going to go to File and Print, because it's very important that you print this like the blackest of the black. Now for this type of film, they do have one for inkjet, which is what we're going to use today. And they do have one for laser. So it is important just to make sure that you're using the right material for your printer. So I'm going to go to settings. All right, everything looks good there. Let's hit OK. So now let's go over, and this is where you get your preview too, okay? So you get a nice preview of what's going to print out. Let's go over to print. And I want to select my HP DeskJet. So I'm also going to click on preferences, and this is where a lot of your settings are going to be changed. What I want to do is I want to jump over to the second tab. Now this will be a little bit different depending on what type of printer and what type of driver you have installed, but this is my one for HP, and I'm going to, let's see, my paper type will be other glossy inkjet papers. My print quality will be best. And then I want to click black ink only. And that is what's going to give me that really super dark black print. Let's hit apply. And I'm going to hit cancel because you notice I have this print border all the way around. So let's hit cancel. Now let's go to print again. It's going to repopulate that print preview for me. Now if you're using like Microsoft Word or something like that, you won't have to do that. But so this actually cuts off a good portion of the bottom here. So let's go back and look. Now you do have the option in Silhouette Studio to turn your print border on or off. Definitely turn it on. And then you see I can actually move this up on my page and scrunch it down just a little bit to make sure that it all prints. Okay, that was a mistake that I made the first time, so I want to stop you guys from making the same mistake. So back to print, Control P. Just give it a good look. It is all within my print border that time. Go to print and just hit print and it will print this on my inkjet. And then I want to show you in the video, the film that we're printing on, it will have a coated side and a glossy side. Now they're both a little bit glossy, so it can be hard to tell, but I'm gonna show you in the video that if you lick the end of your fingertip and touch one side of the paper, you'll be able to tell because it'll react with any type of moisture. So you definitely want to make sure you're printing on the coated side, not the glossy side, on the coated side, because that coated side is meant to help you get a really opaque black print, okay? Now the very first thing that I want to talk about, this project is UV sensitive. So what that means is you really want to open up your box away from windows, maybe if you have an area or if you can draw the shades. So just make sure that you keep that in mind. Anytime that you have to open that black bag to pull out a stencil, you want to act with a quickness and go ahead and proceed to finish the steps of your project. And I also suggest that you watch this video all the way through. That way you don't have any major complications. And then you can come back whenever you're finished and complete your project. All right, guys. So let's talk about some of the things we're going to use today. Now, this is a piece of chipboard. This is just a black 12 by 12 chipboard. And this is a piece of 12 by 12 Mylar stencil film. The chalkboard is going to be one of our project bases because it's very forgiving. And then we are going to pair it up with some acrylic paint. And then we do have another project using a tote bag and screen printing ink.
You have a squeegee. This is a chalky finish material that we're going to mix in with the paint. This is a UV emulsion stencil film. So what that means is that it begins to set once it's exposed to UV light. So I'm going to do some experimenting with that with you today, as well as showing you how to take it out and just use it in the sunlight. These films here. Now these are inkjet printable. So what that means is that you need to have an inkjet printer to use these to their full extent. And they are a milky finish. Now you have, if you're used to working with HTV, you'll probably be able to feel it, but you have a glossy side and a less glossy side. I wouldn't call it a matte side, but one side is coated with an emulsion fluid that will help to get your ink as black as possible, which is going to be very important. But you can always tell which side is coated. If you lick your finger and stick it to the top and see how I got like a little imprint, okay? So if you need to know, because this is the side that you're going to print on, you're going to print on the side that is coated to work with your emulsion stencil. Okay. Now I have in fact already printed mine. Here we go. Now I'm actually going to go ahead and play with this little heart down here. So what you want to do is take one out and put the other one right back in. And if possible, use this as far away from your windows as you can. So this is your stencil film. Okay, so you can feel one side is a matte side, one side is a glossy side. And what we're going to do today, right now, is I'm just going to cut a small piece. Okay, now I'm putting my blue stencil film back in the black bag. Okay, anytime that you're not directly using it, put it back in that black bag. Because the catch is, if you get too much UV light exposure, then that is what's going to cause your stencil not to work. So the whole point of this chipboard and Mylar is just to form a sandwich. And what you want to do is, you'll notice I printed this, and well, you may not notice, I printed this in a mirrored fashion. So for my heart, it doesn't matter. It makes it a really good test, but I want glossy side up, and then I want my print ink side down. I'm just going to sandwich it with my stencil film here. And then I have a UV flashlight, okay? So I'm going to expose this using the flashlight because I don't want to ruin an entire stencil sheet. Now, this is something that you can do in your kitchen sink. I do not have a kitchen sink here at the shop, so I'm just using a little bit of water. And then I also have a spray bottle here. I'm going to remove my stencil film and separate it. Now, I can keep this if I want to. And obviously, you cannot see anything yet. What I've heard is that it works best if you soak it for a few minutes. So I'm going to let it soak in the water. And believe it or not, I can actually see where my heart is. Okay, so what I want to do is I'm going to remove this from the water. And what you need to do, the reason that you need the water bottle, is you need to be able to spray. Now, I have reduced this down to a very fine stream. Now, all of the other videos that you will watch will show you about using the spray nozzle on your sink. And of course, that's going to be the fastest way for you. But in case that's not an option for you, then this is another option. Grab a water bottle that has a very straight stream that you can use. All right, can you see where it's washing away? So that's what you're going for. You want to wash this completely away. Okay, there is our stencil. So now I did notice it was separating a little bit from the back. That is completely okay. All right, there we go. But you do want to keep it with the backing, and you want to give this enough time to go ahead and dry out completely before we use it. So I'm gonna set this to the side and allow it to dry, and we will come back. All right, guys, I'm not gonna lie, this is take two. I exposed my design and was rinsing it out and realized I told you guys backwards. So what you wanna do is, this is your black chipboard, and you want to put it glossy side down. And the reason that is because the glossy side is the side that is going to have the adhesive on it. So this is the way that it's going to go onto your blank. So you're going to put it like this. So you want to put it like that on your design, and then have your text just like this where you can read it. And then cover with your Mylar stencil. I'm going to take this outside for the exposure. So even though it's kind of cold and icky out here, I'm just outside my shop, and I just wanted to show you, this is actually a pretty overcast day for me, but don't forget that UV rays are still available to you, so to speak. They teach us down here in Florida to watch out for those UV rays, even when it's not sunny outside. If this is not something you're comfortable with, if UV rays aren't your forte, then by all means, there are larger UV lamps that you can purchase, and that would make this process a lot easier for you. So completely up to you, but as promised, I just carried this right outside, and I'm gonna stand out here for about 60 seconds, and then I'm gonna go back inside and rinse it out. I'm not gonna show you that part, not because I don't want to, but because it's just gonna be really messy. I'm gonna take it in the bathroom I have here at the shop, but I don't have a sprayer, so I'll just be using the same spray bottle that I used in the first video. But it's the same concept, and I promise if you will take this to your kitchen sink, if you have a clipboard to put it on, that would be really good, or just something flat. Even a baking sheet would be good to kind of hold it from the back for you. But using your sprayer on your kitchen sink, if you have one, would be a lot easier than using a spray bottle. Okay, so while we're waiting on our stencils to dry, and here's just an example, okay? This is our stencil. And right now it's really wet, and the instructions say that you need to let it dry for at least 45 minutes, or that you can take something similar to a hairdryer and dry it yourself. I'm going to let it hang dry until I get too impatient, and then we're and then I'll break out the hairdryer. But
what I have here is 2 ounces of just regular acrylic paint. You can get it from local craft store. You can get it from Walmart, any place like that. And then I'm taking 2 tablespoons of a chalky material. Now, some people will use plaster of Paris. I'm using a type of healing clay that's meant for a face mask that I scored on Amazon. So any type of powder that's going to give it that type of chalky texture will work just fine.
Now, a chalk paste is what's used in a lot of these types of reusable stencils. And I really like that we can make our own because, number one, it's much less expensive. And number two, it really opens up our color options. So I'm just gonna mix this up really good. You can see I'm making quite the mess, but that's okay. I wanna mix it up as good as I can. And you'll see it thickens up quite a bit, quite a bit. So what I'm going to do, you remember our little heart stencil that we made. I'm actually going to do a little bit of practice. Okay. I mixed this up as much as I could, try to get it as smooth as I could. Now, don't beat yourself up if it's not as smooth as you would like it to be. That's okay. And then this is just a little rubber stencil. All right. Scored it from Amazon. And I'm just going to take a little bit of my chalky paste and smooth it into my stencil. And there we go. So I can repeat this as many times as I want. But one thing is that once you are done, you are going to want to take this stencil and immediately wash it out, okay? Because the paint will start to dry in the fine mesh that makes up your stencil. So you can reuse this, and it's adhesive, so it will stick in place. And you can come back and make as many little hearts as you want. Now, like I said, this is my tester. Okay. So, of course, I have not a whole lot of work area to work with here. But hopefully you'll realize how little paint this takes. How little of the chalky paint it takes. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, and from what I've heard too, a lot of crafters, if they're using a lot of stencils in one sitting, they'll just keep like a bucket of water, and then you can drop these in the bucket of water to keep that paint from drying out. Now, it's not that drying out will ruin your stencil, but it's just a lot harder to get the paint out after it dries. All right, guys, so here I am with my stencil from my chalkboard. And just a little tip, when you're choosing a place to hang up or lay out your stencil, do not lay it on a cardboard box. Ask me how I know. So I did get a little bit of the cardboard box that stuck, but it should not adversely affect my stencil. So we are going to go ahead and use it. So I've just laid it down, and just like I did with our other stencil, I'm gonna come grab a little bit of our chalk paint, and I'm literally just going to squeegee it into the design area. Now I cut mine a little close to the top here, so just make sure you watch your edges. Once I feel like I have good coverage, I'm just gonna grab one corner and pull up. Ta-da, there we go. So not too bad. This is obviously my first try. Now, if I'm not happy with this, then I can either come back in here and touch it up, or I can wipe it and try again. But this guy needs to go ahead and go be rinsed out. That way I will be able to let him dry and use him again, because being able to reuse the stencil is what this is all about. So I am gonna go ahead and slide this off to the side to dry, and let's get the chalk paint out of the way. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about using this with our screen printing ink and our screen printing stencil. Now you may notice that my stencil is purple. And that is because Icon Art actually has a stencil for fabrics and then a stencil for regular stencils. So this is technically the one for fabric, and I'm going to use it with my screen printing ink, but I'm going to use it in a very similar fashion. I'm going to get some screen printing ink on here and just brush it through my stencil. And there we go. So as you noticed, I don't feel like I did anything special other than constantly add ink and press it in. I feel like this method is a lot easier than a lot of the screen printing ink tutorials that you find to use with your cutting machine. And once again, this is a stencil that I will just be able to, I'm gonna soak it in some water and then just give it a gentle wash with my hands and hang it up to dry, and I can use it again and again and again. So it's really good for mass producing and then also really easy, and screen printing ink is very inexpensive. So let's go ahead and give a little recap of our projects here. Now, of course, like I said, and I feel like I've probably overly repeated myself, the great thing about these projects is the ability to reuse the stencils. And the reason I wanted to include it is because you can do it without your cutting machine. The benefit to using the printable is that obviously there's no cutting and weeding. It's really super easy, and you have the ability to use very detailed and small designs that normally you would have a problem cutting with your machine. Now, this is the tote bag. This is our sign. I do love them both. And of course, while you're watching the tutorial, you see that I do only use the stencil one time, and then I rush it in and go ahead and soak it. That way the paint or ink does not dry in the stencil. But in reality, if I was mass producing these, I would be able to use that stencil over and over and over. As it is, I can still use it over and over, but once you wash it, you do want to allow it to dry. Now, using either acrylic paint, especially making it into that chalky paste that we like, or using screen printing ink is so super inexpensive. So hopefully the next time you need to mass produce a product, or guys, even if you just need to use a color that you don't have and heat transfer vinyl, then screen printing is a great option for that, because you can actually use a whole range of different mediums to create your own ink to use on textiles. So you really get a lot of benefits of using these reusable stencils. And of course, it's just a really fun craft to try. So guys, how did you feel about our reusable stencils? Now, obviously, I really enjoyed them. I loved them so much. I made two of them, and I'm really looking forward to being able to use them again in the future without having to go through all of the hard work again, right? Because all my hard work is behind me. Now, what I really love most about it is that using the printable format really opens up a lot of doors for me, because I don't have to worry about cutting and weeding any fine details or anything like that. So that part is really, really beneficial. Now, of course, guys, if you have any questions or comments about anything that we did today, please make sure that you leave that below. I do love to hear from you guys. I love answering your questions. And of course, this is the time where I go ahead and ask you guys, make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, share with a crafty friend. All of that really helps to support the channel so that we keep bringing you these videos all the time. We really try to come out with videos every single day, and hopefully we're covering content that you guys enjoy. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, guys, but I really do appreciate it. I appreciate you stopping by, and we will see you again next time.